Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Connie Sessoms. I am the lead person for driver education for Charlotte Mecklenburg Schools. In that capacity, I direct all the operations for driver education. Background. Graduated with a degree in driver education, and I've done some other things in education since, but in 1976, so I've done this a long time. I am the chair of the Driver Education Advisory Committee, a position appointed by the State Superintendent of Public Instruction and ratified by the State Board of Education. I sit on that committee as chair. I am the immediate past president of the American Driver and Traffic Safety Education Association. It's a national group that represents driver educators across the nation, parts of Canada, Puerto Rico, and the Virgin Islands. I'm also the executive director of the North Carolina Driver and Traffic Safety Education Association. I also sit on a federal task force called ANSTE, which is the Association of National Stakeholders in Traffic Safety Education. We advise NHTSA, the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, about driver education issues across the nation. So I'm deep rooted in driver education. It is who I am, and it is what I do. But I want to bring your attention to North Carolina and the plight that we now find ourselves in. And I'm going to blame it on the Legislative Assembly in Raleigh. Because driver education has been a mainstay and a department within public instruction since 1957. It has been funded by the state since that time. And I want to go ahead and mention now, and it will play into some of our conversation later. But in 1957, a driver training fund was established by taking $1 or adding $1 to your vehicle registration. Everybody who renewed their tag within a year was charged that extra dollar. In 1975, it went to $2. In 1977, it was increased to $3. The Department of Motor Vehicles still collects that $3. And in their defense, they have funded driver education until this past budget legislative year, where driver's ed is now put in a non-recurring funding status as of June 30. But they're still collecting that $3. Now, the folks in Raleigh will tell you that that driver training fund and that $3 was disconnected by a repeal, and I don't have the year, but at some point it was repealed. But again, in their defense, they have always funded driver's ed up until this year, but they're still collecting that $3. So you know, that's an issue for us. We have several legislators who are co-sponsoring the bill, and obviously they're looking for others to do as well, but they intend to co-sponsor a bill to put driver's ed back in the budget and sort of settle all these funding issues for once and for all. And I can mention names. Representative Pat Hurley out of Randolph County, Representative Linda Johnson out of Cabarrus, Representative John Torbett out of Gaston, and Representative Becky Carney out of Mecklenburg have all agreed to co-sponsor a bill to put funding back in place. Now the challenge is going to be in the Senate. the House is on board with offering driver education and paying for it. But the Senate, we got a lot of opponents there. The folks in transportation are opposed to having funds come out of the Highway Trust Fund, which is where this money ends up. It's collected at DMV, transferred to the Highway Trust Fund. It's taken out of there, goes to DPI to be distributed across the state in each LEA. But the folks in transportation are saying we don't want any money coming out of the Highway Fund except that to build bridges and roads. And you know, as I was discussing earlier, and it is a fact that our teenagers on the highway arguably could be considered part of the transportation system, and that money is being well spent there. The folks in the education sector of Raleigh are saying that they can't afford to take on this expense because they've sustained budget cuts across the years as well. Let me just point out that more teenagers die on our streets and highways than all the other reasons that teenagers die combined. That includes heart disease, stroke, cancer. In other words, teenagers aren't supposed to die. We have more teenagers dying on our streets and highways nowadays than any other reason that you can think of. Now, albeit the number is low, but as I said, the caveat there is that teenagers aren't supposed to die. They're supposed to grow old and have a good life. Just to put it in perspective, we teach across this state, we teach about 106, well, last year it was 106,000 teens successfully got their license last year. 106,000. 16-year-old or 15-year-olds moving into 16. If you take, and I'm just going to, just for sake of numbers, I'm going to say 100,000 16-year-olds, 100,000 17-year-olds, 100,000 18-year-olds, 100,000 19-year-olds. That's 400,000 over 4 years that are now driving. And just to give you some perspective, 113 16-year-olds died last year. So when you hear the argument that driver's ed does not work, I lift those numbers up to you. We've got 100,000 16-year-olds, and we reached all but 113 of them. We reached them and helped them to navigate the roads and possibly save their life and someone else's life. So the sheer numbers would tell you driver's ed works.